Hello everyone and welcome back to a brand new video. Dungeon Quest has finally been updated after 3 months. It has been updated before, but this is the update which has new dungeon. Okay, the update notes. First, a new dungeon has been created and put into the game known as Orbital Outpost. Second, snowflakes, which I'm going to be showing you guys now. First, the Red Holiday site from the Snowflakes event. The Snowflakes event has ended, but Winnie said that with extra snowflakes you can obtain new items. You press the snowflake button, this is the context it shows you. The stuffs are pretty expensive. That's the reason I bought only 2 of them, as I had only 6k snowflakes. I bought the frozen turkey onesie and red holiday scythe, which cost roughly 5,000-6,000 snowflakes. Okay, first, the Red Holiday Scythe. It's an epic weapon and it looks like this, but I really think that this idea was really lazy of Winnie to put this in the game, because the blue Holiday Scythe, as you guys know, the Blue Holiday Scythe looks like this, and the Red Holiday Scythe is the same copy of the Blue Holiday site with a red color variant. We can say that. Okay, the frozen turkey. The frozen turkey is the same thing but with darker shades. Coming to the cosmetics. As I have no Robux left, I'm just going to be showing you guys this cosmetics. This is the cosmetic, guys. I think the casual and pink saber cosmetics are pretty lazy. The casual one is the same as the one like the 11-1 look what you have. And the pink saber is just the color. Okay guys, that was my friend Groove. A huge shout out to him. Okay, now this is a run of Orbital Outpost Insane No Hardcore. I give a huge shout out to ReadyMan80 who helped me film this video. Without him, this would be impossible. And here you go guys, you can enjoy the gameplay. Okay guys, this is the run, and please enjoy the gameplay. This is the place where we spawn, and again a huge shout out to him. I really, really thank him for helping me make this video a huge success for you guys. Okay, let's start. As you guys see, this is the area where we spawn, and as you walk through, we get the first group. This group is like all the other first groups. It's very easy to defeat with good equipped stuff. And this part was a sneak peek that Joey, who's known as J Cafe and the co-owner of this game, posted on Discord. Okay, let's move on to the second group. The second group is also like the first group, which is like pretty easy to defeat. And here you go guys. After this, we approach the boss, who's known as the Destroyer. He has pretty good RMG attacks, like machine gun and stuff. And he does like hell a lot of damage. One hit from him is like 8 to 9 million. Okay, here you go guys. This is the gameplay of the Destroyer. As you guys can see on the screen, it's pretty okay-ish to defeat him. He's not that hard, but he is hard, I must tell. I'll be back after we defeat this boss. Before going, you can see the galaxy background on the right. On the right side, I guess. That is the thing, or that's the clue which we have that in our minds, like this map is in space. As you guys can see the galaxy there, so this map is from space basically. I don't know why I'm repeating stuff. Okay, I'll be back once we finish the Destroyer. Okay guys, this is the close-up look of the galaxy as shown in the video. Hopefully you like the galaxy and hopefully you like this video. Make sure to like, subscribe and share this video as much as possible. I'll meet you guys once we reach the second boss. Here we go guys, we have approached the second boss. Not the second boss, the second mini boss. He is known as the Tesla Master and he is pretty easy to defeat. He has decent RNG skills, but if you get hit once, your health gets drained like hell. Here you go guys, this is the gameplay of him, hopefully you enjoy it. Okay guys, we have approached the final boss of this dungeon and map. He is known as Lord Varosh. He has 3 main attacks which drains like hell a lot of amount of your health. The first attack, as you can see, the orb of stun which pulls you and grabs you with that orb and makes you unmovable. The second attack, as you guys saw, was the orb and it has a huge impact on your health. If you have 20 million health and you are soloing or you're doing or you are a DPS in the game, you are going to get one shot. And the third attack is known as the health, sucking the health and regaining it. As you guys can see, we have done decent damage and you saw guys, we use a green beam to suck my health and put it into his. He sucked my health and drained it and he gained his health. This is one of the most difficult boss to beat in this game currently and we are doing pretty fine. I give a huge shout out to ReadyMan80 for helping me make this video and helping me make this video a huge success for you guys. We are almost approaching the end and as you guys can see, ReadyMan80 just got one-shotted with that single orb. Okay guys, we have almost finished the boss and huge shout out to him and well played by him. Hopefully you guys like this video. That's going to be it for this week's video. I'll see you guys next week. Until then, stay healthy. Peace out. Goodbye.